climate change is real, global warming is also real. We're trying as much as possible to eliminate greenhouse gases from the atmosphere that are responsible for global warming so we can slow down climate change. Of course, we're starting a bit late. It's something that should have been started 20, 25 years ago, but it's never too late to make a change. So my research area is looking at industry. Industry is responsible globally for over 30% of global CO2 emissions. If we can eliminate that or reduce that drastically, we are on our way to dealing with climate change. The challenge, however, is the technologies you need to bring about low CO2 emissions are expensive. So we need to design the energy system for the future and determine how to reduce the cost. Government can design policy interventions that support commercialization of technologies that can bring about low to net zero carbon, especially in the industrial sector. This will go a long way in increasing adoption of these technologies. While we're waiting for policy interventions, industry needs to innovate their business model. Because by innovating their business model, they can redefine what competitiveness means, and it's possible to reduce the cost associated with getting to net zero carbon. It's exciting to be working on industrial decarbonization in a time where it's so topical. And what excites me about it is the challenge. Industry is so complicated. Every industrial plant, even if a plant in country A and a plant in country B producing the same product will probably have different processes if they are owned by different people. So industry is so diverse, and for me it's accounting for that diversity, that industrial characteristics. It's mind-blowing, it's challenging, but it keeps me on my feet.